Stargazers and sky watchers, an alert for you. An eclipse will be visible in the Kansas City Metro this weekend. So if you're planning on watching, make sure you have the right eye protection. Fox 4's Jacob Kittlestats joins us now from Union Station Live. Jake, Science City plans to give out 1,000 pairs of those special viewing glasses to visitors. They've got a watch party Saturday morning.
Yeah, that's right, Lauren. Buy a ticket. You'll get sunglasses as well. And this eclipse, it's going to be starting just before 10:30 a.m. and reaching maximum coverage at 11:50, just before noon there. And then it'll all be over at 1:20 in the afternoon.
27, 26.
Here's video from 2017, the last eclipse with Kansas City in its path. That was a total solar eclipse. There won't be another one here for about another 200 years. The one coming this Saturday is what's known as an annular eclipse, depicted here at the Arvin Gottlieb Planetarium at Union Station.
Again, with proper eye protection, or viewing this indirectly, it'll look like the moon is taking a bite out of the sun. Now here in Kansas City, this is about as good as you are going to get. It doesn't necessarily matter how rare it is. You know, solar eclipses, lunar eclipses, they happen twice a year. The trick is you gotta be in the right place to see it. It might be over the ocean, so you'll miss that one.
People in the path of totality are between California and Texas. They will see a so-called ring of fire, which looks like this, happening when the moon is at its furthest point away from the Earth, making it appear smaller than usual.
Now remember, regular sunglasses in a situation like this just won't cut it. You might remember from 6 years ago, those special viewing glasses that filter out harmful types of light. That's what you need to be seeking out from a reputable place that sells them, like here at the Planetarium Science City, if you want to pick up a pair beforehand. And another part of this, of course, is that it's very weather dependent if you're going to be able to see this eclipse. So let's toss things over to Jacob Lanier with a look at what might be in store for our forecast. Jacob.
Yeah, that's right, Jake. Remember back in 2017 when we had that total eclipse here near Kansas City? Some people were under some clouds and they tried to drive out from underneath them to see the eclipse. That may be a scenario we see this time with the potential for some cloud cover this weekend. But this time it's an annular eclipse and we're only going to see a partial eclipse. This total annular eclipse is what's going to be visible back across the western and southern parts of the United States, really from Portland through Utah, New Mexico, down towards San Antonio, Texas. Here in Kansas City, I'm expecting about 60% is going to be our peak eclipse. And as Jake was saying, that's about 11:50 on Saturday morning. So this is what it'll kind of look like as we go through late morning Saturday, especially with binoculars, telescope, with your safety glasses on for sure. There's that 61 maximum eclipse, and then the eclipse will end there as we head after 1 o'clock. So of course, the key here is the cloud cover forecast. Unfortunately, a lot of our guidance right now has some pretty thick cloud cover from Missouri, Kansas, and areas up towards the north. The totality path actually has decent viewing down across Texas, but here in the Midwest, it might be hard to see that partial eclipse with more overcast skies as we get by the weekend. We'll also have some cooler air as well. I'll show you the big cold front on the way in our long-range forecast coming up here in a little bit, guys.